have your Bibles with you, just open with me in the book of Philippians chapter 4, verse 4, and 1 Thessalonians 5, 16. Let us all read. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, say rejoice. 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 says, rejoice always. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this evening, Lord God. Thank you so much for this opportunity to once again hear your word in this place, Lord God. I pray, Father, let your Holy Spirit open our hearts, open our minds as we understand thy word, O God. And may we apply this understanding, Lord, this truth of thy word in our daily lives. We thank you. May your name be glorified in this place. In Jesus' name, everybody say amen.
Amen.
Okay, praise God. Pwede po makakaupo muna po kayo. Okay, once again, we welcome po yung family ni Ken, si nanay po. Welcome po ka, isa Dubai, at saka yung kapatid ni Sir Ken. Welcome po, and the husband. Welcome in this service. We glorify the Lord sa ating pong gawain, mga kapatid. Ang ating pong pinag-aaralan is our series about the most repeated commands in the Bible. Amen? The most repeated commands in the Bible. Ano yung una nating pinag-aralan, if you remember? First is what?
Praise
the Lord. Everybody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Secondly, what we talked about is about fear not. Just tell to your neighbor, fear not. Huwag tayong matakot. Amen? Fear not. And last week, we talked about thanks or give thanks. We should always give thanks to the Lord in no matter what is our circumstances. Amen? Today, ang ating pag-aaralan is about rejoice or rejoicing in the Lord. Being happy always in the Lord. Amen? Life is so difficult, right? Mahirap po ang buhay, mga kapatid. Life is difficult. We live in a fallen world full of suffering, difficulties, pain, and sickness. Laging may sakit, di ba? Si Wuhu, may sakit. Laging may sakit, may karamdaman, may pain, may suffering, may failure, mayroong disappointment, mayroong breakups, and everything. We experience these things in lives. But in spite of this, God wants His children to rejoice always. Kahit ano po yung nangyayari, kapatid, God wants you to be happy. God wants you to rejoice in life. Amen?
Amen.
What does rejoice mean? Ano bang ibig sabihin ng rejoice? The word rejoice mentioned 161 times. Rejoice, 38 times. And I think it's there. Rejoice mentioned in the Bible 161 times. Rejoice, which is past tense, mentioned 38 times. Rejoicing mentioned 21 times. Joy mentioned 179 times. So, total of 399 times. So this joy is very important in the Bible. It is being repeated all over in the scripture. So we should talk about joy. It is a very important topic. The word rejoice is very important topic. Different. There are three different Greek words for joy. Number one is chairo. Chairo, which is a primary verb. It is a verb to be full of cheer. That is family, happy or well off. Everybody say happy.
Happy.
So pwede pa lang maging happy ang isang Kristiyano. We can be happy in life, all right? Calmly or well off, impersonal, especially as a salutation. It can be used as salutation in a letter. Meeting or parting, be well. Or like when someone is going, you will tell Cairo. So it's being happy, be cheerful. Be farewell, be glad, Godspeed, greetings, or hail, or joy. Rejoice. Number one is chairo. Everybody say chairo. Ayan, nagigreek na kayo. Ha? Ibig sabihin, rejoice. Alright? Secondly, sa Philippians 4:4, makikita natin yung chairo. I think it's there. Balik tayo, wala doon. Back. Nandiyan ba? Ah, wala. Alright. Chairo. Second is euprino. Tatlong Greek word po na kasi as I told you before, mga kapatid, Greek is very important because these words in English are always the same. For example, love. But in Greek, there are five different kinds of love. But in this particular topic, rejoice, if you read the English Bible, it we will always read rejoice. But there are different Greek word for rejoice. One is what? Kairo. Second is euprino. What is euprino? To put in a good frame of mind. That is rejoice. Fair, make glad, be merry, or rejoice. It's also almost the same. Secondly, or thirdly, o yung euprino, makikita natin yung paggamit ng kairo and the euprino. I think, nandyan ba yun? Next slide, please. See, mga kapatid, Romans 12:15 says rejoice, which is kairo in Greek. With those who rejoice, which is kairo also, and weep to those who weep. But in Romans 15, same scripture, same letter of Paul, 15:10, again he says rejoice, but the Greek word is euprino. The same word in English, but different in Greek. So it's very important for us to understand. All right? The third meaning of rejoice is agalayo. Agalayo, from agan, properly to jump for joy. Amen? Ito yung ginamit kay Habakkuk. Sabi ni Habakkuk, I will rejoice in the Lord. I will jump for joy. Whatever is happening in my life, I will rejoice. I will jump for joy. That is exult, be glad with exceeding joy, rejoice greatly. See three different Greek word for rejoice. Kairo, euprino, and agalayo. Sabi ng Matthew 5:12, rejoice, which is agalayo. Or jump for joy. And be glad because great is your reward in heaven. Amen? Why should you should rejoice? Because great is your reward in heaven. You should jump for joy. You should jump for joy because great is your reward in heaven. For in the same way, they persecuted the prophets who were before you. So those are the three different kinds of rejoicing or in Greek word. Rejoice can also be translated to happiness. Everybody say happiness.
Happiness.
Gusto ko happy ka. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, gusto ko happy ka. I want you to be happy. So rejoice can be translated to happiness. So most of the time, people think about God as cruel. People think about us like He doesn't want you to be happy in life. Diba? Mga kapatid, parang ang Diyos, parang killjoy. We think God as killjoy. But God wants you to be happy. God wants you to rejoice in life. Yung kairo, a primary verb, to be full of cheer. To be happy. Amen? To be happy, a primary verb, to be full of cheer, that is calmly happy or well off. He wants you to be happy. Happiness is not found in anything external. This kind of happiness that is being said here, being talked about by Paul here, happiness is not about in anything external. It is a certain state of the soul that is filled with the peace of God. If you have peace of God, you will be happy, truly happy in life. Amen? Magiging tunay kang masaya sa buhay. Bakit? Meron kang kapayapaan sa puso mo. It is not found in anything external. Probably you are happy because you have many things in life. You are well off. Amen? Marami kang pera, marami kang kaibigan. But this kind of happiness is nothing external. Cannot be found in external. Happiness which source is not external. This happiness springs from our spirit. It is a state of being contented with God. Contented with God. You are happy when you have nothing. You are happy when you have something. You have something. You are happy. You have nothing. You are happy. Because why? You are dependent on God. You are contented on God. Amen? Philippians 4:11 to 13 says, Paul says, I am not saying this because I am in need. For I have learned to be content, whatever circumstances. Everybody say, whatever the circumstances. All right? I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in every situation, and any and every situation, whatever well fed or hungry, whatever living in plenty or in want, I can Give me strength. Most of the time, we misinterpret this verse. Ginagamit ito sa basketball and athletes. I can do all things. If you want to be successful in life, usually they are using this verse. I can do all things. But specifically, Paul is talking about whatever circumstances he was experiencing as a Christian, he can do it. Why? Because of the strength of Christ. Amen? Because of the power of Christ. Philippians 4:4 says, rejoice in the Lord always. Well, he is able to rejoice because he is content with God. Whatever circumstances he is experiencing, he is contented with God. He experienced joy from the Lord. Why Paul is content in whatever circumstances? Because of the Lord. Amen? Why he was able to rejoice always? Because of the Lord. Amen? Because of the Lord. Christians are commanded to be happy in life. Christian life is never gloomy or boring. Usually we think about Christianity as boring. Ah, Christian, they are boring. Being Christian is boring, is a boring life. But God wants you to be happy. Just tell your neighbor, be happy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Spurgeon says, sabi ni Spurgeon, mga kapatid, just listen to this. Sabi ni Spurgeon, I am bound to mention among curiosity of the churches that I have known many deeply spiritual Christian people who have been afraid to rejoice. Are you afraid to rejoice? I'm afraid to rejoice because pastor will see me or my father will scold me. When I was a child, ganun yung mga sitwasyon mga kapatid. Eh, parang kailangan, when you are inside the church, dapat ano ka, prim and proper. Hindi ka makabasag pinggan. We are afraid to rejoice, but God wants you to rejoice. God wants you to be happy in life. Some take such a view of religion that is to them a sacred duty to be gloomy. Parang sacred duty yun. Kasama sa pagiging Kristiyano, kailangan yung ano, malungkot, seryoso, hindi tumatawa, hindi nakangiti. Parang sacred duty yun. Di ba nararanasan yun? Lalo na siguro yung mga laking simbahan. Sino yung laking simbahan dito? You grew up in the church. Anyone? Parang hindi pwedeng. Bawal tumawa. Bawal ngumiti. Di ba mga kapatid? Kung naranasan nyo. It is not sacred duty to be gloomy. Being a Christian, we should be happy. We should be rejoicing. Amen? Rejoice in the Lord. We should be rejoicing. But this is not a carnal happiness. It is not a carnal rejoicing. When you say happiness, what comes on your mind? Food, drinking, alcohol, many friends, many girls, many boys. Ano pa? Shopping, partying, watching series on Netflix. When you say happiness, what comes in your mind? But this kind of happiness is nothing carnal. You find happiness not on doing what satisfies your fleshly desires, but you find happiness in fulfilling God's will in your life. Amen? You find happiness not in something that fulfills your desire, your fleshly desires. I want to drink, be alcoholic, and being a shopaholic and everything. But your happiness can only be found in what? Doing God's will. No? You find happiness not on doing what satisfies your fleshly desire. You find happiness in fulfilling God's desire. If you're doing God's will in your life, you feel satisfied and happy in life. Amen? This is not carnal happiness or carnal way of rejoicing. That's why Philippians 4:4 says, rejoice in the Lord always. I say again, rejoice. Joy is one of the fruit of the Spirit. It is expected of Christian because it is a natural result of having received salvation. The joy comes on account of what Christ has done. Irrelevant, ever say irrelevant, of whatever other circumstances are happening in our lives, in one's life. Whatever circumstances you are in, you are happy, you are rejoicing. Why? Because you are saved. You have salvation from the Lord. Amen? You are happy in life. What? Kaya nga irrelevant yung whatever circumstances. This rejoicing is first, it's not carnal rejoicing. Rejoice is a choice. Everybody say, rejoice is a choice. So whatever circumstances you are in right now, remember that rejoicing is a choice. To rejoice is a choice. Whether you will choose to be gloomy in life, to be sad, to be bitter, to remain in pain, to be melancholic, or to rejoice. It's a choice. Mga kapatid. When Paul wrote his letter to Philippians, he was in the prison. Take note of that. When he wrote, rejoice in the Lord always, to the Philippians, remember he was inside the prison. He was writing letter to the Philippians. He did not let these circumstances influence his rejoicing, his attitude of rejoicing. He remained rejoicing in spite of the situation. Amen, mga kapatid? He did not base his happiness to what is happening. Do not base your happiness to what is happening around you. Your joy should come from the Lord. Your circumstances should not dictate your cheerfulness. Choose to rejoice in the Lord. Choose to rejoice. It's a choice. Amen. It's a choice. It's a choice. It's a choice to rejoice. Am I going to rejoice or no? Am I going to stay in this kind of situation? To be sad, to be gloomy, to be despair, to be in that situation? Or no? Your choice will eventually become your lifestyle. No? Lagi bang malungkot? Anong lifestyle? Number two, why should we rejoice? Bakit tayo, una, what is rejoice? We understand that this kind of rejoicing comes from the Lord. It's not from outside source, but it's from internal source. It's from the Spirit. Why should we rejoice? Bakit tayo magre-rejoice? Number one, because God commanded it. It's a command from the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord. Psalm 32, verse 11. Everybody read. Amen. It's a command from the Lord to rejoice. So if you don't feel like rejoicing, rejoice. Why? God commanded you. God wants you to rejoice. God wants you to be happy. Amen. Nalulungkot ba yung katabi ninyo? God wants you to be happy. God wants you to rejoice. God commanded you to rejoice. Sometimes we think that commands are boring and restricts our freedom. But the truth is, God's commands are always for our good. Parang restriction yung command ng Panginoon. But in fact, why? It is for our benefit when God is commanding something. He doesn't want you to stay in that state of life. God wants you to be happy. He does not want you to stay in a state of sadness, bitterness, and sorrow. He does not want you to stay in the dark. Amen? Don't stay in the dark. Amen? To put it in the balance, there are seasons of sorrows, but God doesn't want you to dwell on those states. Yes, we are experiencing sorrows, difficulties, problems in life. But God wants you to stay sad, to stay sorrowful, to stay in despair. Amen. It is a command. Number two, because we always have hope. Amen. Why should I rejoice? Do I have reason to rejoice? Yes, you have reason to rejoice. You always have hope. Amen. Amen. Sometimes we don't want to rejoice. We don't feel like rejoicing. Because we don't have reason to rejoice. I lost my job. I lost my partner. Everything. I have zero balance in the account, and the credit card company is calling me. I don't have reason, Lord. I don't have reason to rejoice, Lord. I tell you, you have always reason to rejoice because you always have hope. Amen. Amen. Pag buhay ka pa, may hope ka pa. Amen. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace and in believing so that by the power of the Holy Spirit, you may abound in hope. You have reason to rejoice. You have hope. You always have hope. May pag-asa pa kapatid. Romans 15:13. For God's children's suffering are always temporary. There is always hope in the Lord. Walang permanenteng suffering sa anak ng Diyos, ha? Amen? Kung hindi mananampalataya, if you don't believe, of course, there will be suffering in hell. But if you believe, if you are a children of God, you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, there is no such thing as permanent suffering. There is no such thing as permanent suffering. For God's children, suffering are always temporary. Walang forever sa suffering. Walang forever sa problema, kapatid. You always have reason to rejoice. Amen. You always have reason to rejoice. Amen. Revelation 21 verse 4, He will wipe. No, papawirin. No? Papahirin, sorry. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. Ngayon, umiiyak ka, pero darating ang panahon, wala nang pain, wala nang sickness. Probably you are suffering from some kind of sickness, difficulties. But time will come. Papawiin ng Panginoon, wala nang sakit, wala nang suffering, no more pain, no more suffering, no more crying. He will wipe your tears. Amen? There is always hope. You have reason to rejoice. Number three, because we are on the winning side. Why should I rejoice? Let me tell you another reason why you should rejoice. You are on the winning side. Amen. You don't understand. No, you are always on the winning side. You have reason to rejoice. Amen. Amen. In the Old Testament, joy is closely related to victory. Victory, mga kapatid, over one's enemies. For example, in Psalm, when David returned from killing the Philistine, he was met with joy and dancing. In the New Testament, it's the same. Joy is still used for victory, as shown by the disciples returning with joy, since the devil's evil spirits listened to them. However, the victory focuses more on salvation. Why you should rejoice? Because you are saved. You are on the winning side. Amen. Laging tagumpay yung ating pintahan, kapatid. You are on the winning team. You have reason to rejoice. When we are in God's side, we are always in the winning side. Amen. 1 Corinthians 15:57 says, "But thanks be to God, He gives us what?
Victory."
Everybody say victory.
Victory
to our Lord Jesus Christ. So why you should rejoice? Probably you are experiencing many difficulties, problems in life. But why you should rejoice? You are on the winning side. You are on the winning team. Whatever battles you are facing today, God is on your side. The battle is the Lord's. Kanyang laban na ito, kapatid. Amen. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Let me tell you a spoiler alert. What is a spoiler alert? Jesus will win.
Amen.
At the end of everything, pag nagunaw na ang mundo, mga kapatid, siya pa rin ang tagumpay. Siya ang nagtatagumpay ngayon at siya pa rin ang magtatagumpay. That is your reason to rejoice. Parang pelikula, di ba? Alam mo na yung katapusan ng pelikula, kapatid. Tagumpay ang Panginoong Jesus. So bakit ka magre-rejoice? You know, you are on the winning side. Amen? Another reason why you should rejoice, because it develops trust. Yung pagtitiwala natin sa Panginoon. Whatever circumstances in life, and you decided to rejoice, you choose to rejoice in the Lord, it develops a heart that is trusting God's sovereignty. So what you are in that situation, particular situation in your life, you feel you don't feel like rejoicing. Kasi may problema eh, bakit ako magre-rejoice? Let me tell you something, kapatid. Magtiwala ka sa Panginoon, alam niya ang nangyayari. Trust God's sovereignty. Lastly, another reason is because it guards our heart. Why should we rejoice? Choosing to rejoice in the Lord in spite of trials and difficulties in life will guard your heart from harmful thoughts and emotions such as bitterness, resentment, anxiety, and etc. So I choose to rejoice rather than to live in despair, rather than to live in sorrow, to live in sadness. So it will guard your heart from these negative thoughts. Ano man yung ating nasa isip. Amen? Yung bitterness mo. Pinipili mo mag-rejoice sa Panginoon eh. Nawalan ka ng trabaho instead of cursing your company, cursing your boss. You choose to rejoice. Amen? It will guard your heart from harmful emotion and attitude. Lastly, third point, mga kapatid, when should we rejoice? When should you rejoice? When you are successful in life? When should we rejoice? Joy that is not seasonal. Amen? Yung joy na ito, it's not seasonal. Amen? Philippians 4:4 says, rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Everybody say rejoice.
Rejoice.
Palagi ka daw mag-rejoice, palagi kang maging masaya. Bakit mga kapatid? This joy is not seasonal. If the Lord is the reason for your joy should not be seasonal. God should be the ultimate reason and foundation of your joy. Amen? He is the reason. Bakit ka magsasaya? Because God is the reason for your joy. Hindi dahil nanalo ka ng loto, hindi dahil masaya ang pamilya mo, hindi dahil may pera ka, that's not your reason to rejoice. Your reason to rejoice is in the Lord. The Lord is your reason to rejoice. The Lord is the reason for your joy. It will be joy for all. Hindi star for all season. Ha? Joy for all season. Why? Because God is your reason to rejoice. Amen? Anong sabi rito? Saan ba natin matatagpuan yung joy? Saan natin matatagpuan yung joy? Next. Not in unbelief. Sabi nung ang joy hindi matatagpuan pagiging atheist. Ay, wala di ako naniniwala sa Diyos. Wala itong din ang joy. Sabi ni Voltaire, sabi niya, was an infidel of the most pronounced type. He wrote, I wish I had never been born. I atheist to. Pero sabi niya, sana hindi na ako pinanganak. Wala dun ang joy, kapatid. Not in pleasure. As sasabihin natin, yung kasiyahan ko pagka nakumtan ko na lahat ng pangangailangan ko. Lahat ng gusto ko sa buhay, lahat ng pinapangarap ko pag nakamtan ko, magiging masaya na ako. Sabi ni Lord Byron, live a life of pleasure, if anyone did. He wrote, the worm, the canker, and the grip are mine alone. Matindi sinabi niya, di ba? Sa akin yung grip. Not in money, kahit mayaman pa. Jay Gould, the American millionaire, had plenty of that. When dying, he said, I suppose I am the most miserable man on earth. Hindi mo matatagpuan sa pera. Not in position and fame. Sabi din, si Lord Beaconsfield enjoyed more than his share of abode. He wrote, youth is a mistake. Manhood is struggle. Old age a regret. Not in position and fame. Not in military glory. Si Alexander the Great, kilala natin, that conquered the known world in his day, having done so, he wept in his tent because he said, there are no more worlds to conquer. Wala nang mundong mako-conquer pa. So you cannot find your joy from all of these things. When then is real joy found? The answer is simple. In Christ alone. Amen. In Christ alone. If the Lord is your reason to rejoice, every day is a day to rejoice. If the Lord is your reason to rejoice, Every day is, there is a reason to rejoice. Every day is rejoicing day. Kasi si Lord ang reason mo, hindi dahil mayaman ka, dahil may pera ka o wala. That, those are seasonal. It will come and go. Friends will come and go. People will come and go. But if the Lord is your reason to rejoice, every day is a day to rejoice. Amen. God wants you to always be happy in spite of many troubles we are facing. Kaya nga sabi ng 1 Thessalonians 5:16, rejoice always. This joy is not artificial. Always rejoicing is not artificial. People often say those people who are always happy are those who have many sufferings in life. Diba? This is not artificial. Kasi sinasabi nila, ay, yung masayain sa buhay, maraming problema yan. Amen? Andiyan pa ba kayong mga kapatid? Sinasabi nila, masayain sa buhay. O komedyante, natatandaan nyo, isang komedyante nagpakamatay. American comedian. Kasi diba, nagpakamatay siya eh, diba? So, ang sinasabi nila, pagka masayahin daw, eh, may mga maraming problema. But those, that is what? Artificial happiness. Artificial lang yan, palabas lang eh. Diba? But this joy is not artificial. But Christian happiness is not artificial. We are always happy because of God. If God is everything you have everything you need. Hindi artificial eh. Na happiness eh. The Bible does not invalidate our emotion. Jesus knows what we feel. He can identify with us. But we can be honest and pour out our hearts to God. Our despair and sadness and our sorrow and pains. Hindi, pag sinabing always rejoice, God doesn't invalidate your emotion. Hindi naman sinasabing, oh, may, wala ka, huwag kang magkakaroon ng emotion na, huwag kang malulungkot. Hindi ganun, kapatid. He can identify with us. Naging tao sa ang Panginoon, nagkatawang tao ang Panginoong Jesus. Amen, mga kapatid? Alam ng Panginoon. But we can pour out our heart to God. Our hearts to the Lord. Ano sabi ng Psalm 34 verse 18? The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Alam ng Panginoon yung pinagdadaanan natin. What the Bible discourages is to linger in the same emotion for such a long period of time. Oh, no problem. You can be sad. You can be sorrowful and pour out your heart to God, telling him everything. But what the Bible discourages is to stay or linger in that particular emotion for long period of time. Ang tagal-tagal mo na, isang taon na, malungkot ka pa rin. Diba? Andiyan kayo mga kapatid. Yun ang dinidiscourage ng Biblia. For example, namatayin tayo ng mahal sa buhay. There's no problem in grieving. Diba? You can grieve, you can cry. But the problem, what the Bible discourages is you are prolonging your sadness as if there is no hope. Diba? Isang taon nang namatay, dalawang taon, tatlong, limang taon na, gusto mo pang sumama pa rin sa hukay. Isasama ako sa iyo. Isama muna ako. Pagka naaalala mo, isama muna ako. Huwag naman ganun, kapatid. 1 Thessalonians 4:13 says, sabi dito ng 1 Thessalonians, but we do not want you to be uninformed, brethren, about those who are asleep, yung mga namatay. So that you will not grieve. You can grieve, yes, you can grieve. But do not grieve as though the rest who have no hope. Parang walang nang pag-asa. Ikaw may hope ka eh. Alam mong may kabilang buhay. So huwag tayong mag-grieve na parang wala nang pag-asa. Nandiyan lang sila, mga kapatid. Lumipat lang. Na-promote lang. Ano? Naalala ko yung namatay yung aking busong kapatid. Ano? Medyo hindi pa ako familiar sa ganong pagbati. Eh. Sabi ng mga same school ko, sabi ng mga professor ko, sabi, congratulations. Sabi ko, congratulations. Bakit congratulations? Parang nanibago ako sa bati. Yung pala, kasi nga congratulations, na-promote na yung kapatid ko eh. Ano, sa another level eh. So we have hope. We always have hope, kapatid. Pero we don't invalidate naman yung emotion ng kapatid. Namatayan. Naku, ikain mo lang yan. Don't invalidate. Sabi nga, weep to those who weep. Diba? Sympathize. But we should not invalidate. But we should not prolong such kind of emotion. We should rejoice. Bakit may hope eh? But after crying it all to God, surely He will comfort us and give us peace that cannot understand by human mind. Pagkatapos mo umiyak sa Panginoon, bibigyan kanya ng kapayapaan. Naranasan niyo na yan. Amen. Joy that is not, lastly kapatid, joy that is not temporal. This kind of joy is not temporary. Amen. This is not temporal. Because the source of our joy is in the Lord, this joy is not temporal but eternal. Mga kapatid, makinig kayo. Pains, sufferings, sorrows, and sickness are always temporary. Amen?
Amen?
I want you to listen to this. Pains, sufferings, sorrows, and sicknesses are always temporary. But your reason to rejoice is eternal. Yung karamdamang nararanasan mo, yung problemang nararanasan mo, yung sakit na nararanasan mo ngayon, maaari may cancer, mayroon kang may anumang ramdaman, kapatid, temporary lang yan. But your reason to rejoice is eternal. Sabi ng Luke 10:20, nevertheless, do not rejoice in this, that the spirit are subject to you, but rejoice that your name are recorded in heaven. Sometimes we base our joy in success. Katulad dito mga kapatid, yung mga nagpapalayas sila ng masamang espiritu, diba? Ng demonyo. Nagpapalayas sila ng demonyo. Pagkatapos sila magpalayas, masayang-masaya sila pumunta kay Jesus. Oh, Jesus, we are rejoicing because the enemy or the devil is subject to us. We base our rejoicing in what? In ministerial success or okay na okay yung ministry ko ah. Masaya ako. Those are temporary. These things are temporary, kapatid. Diba? Whatever success you are experiencing in life, those are temporary. But sabi ni Jesus Christ, rejoice that your name is written in the book of life. Magsaya ka kasi ligtas ka, kapatid. Matakot ka kung mamamatay ka mamayang gabi, pupunta ka sa impyerno. But rejoice that your name is written in the book of life. For true believers, there is no permanent suffering. Sabihin ko, walang forever sa suffering, kapatid. Joy comes in the morning.
Amen.
Walang forever sa suffering. Ano man pinagdadaanan natin? But joy comes. Always, always, joy comes in the morning. Hindi magpe-fail yun, kapatid. So, joy always comes in the morning. Psalms 34:5, sing to the Lord, you saint of His praise, His holy name, for His anger lasts only a moment, but His favor lasts a lifetime. Weeping may remain for a night, but rejoicing comes in the morning. The Lord is telling you today that whatever difficulties, pain, suffering, sorrows, and sicknesses you are experiencing right now, it is temporary. It is temporary. 2 Corinthians 4:17 says, listen to this, this is the last verse that I'm going to share tonight, mga kapatid. For momentary light affliction, remember mga kapatid, momentary, just for now. Your affliction is just for now. It's temporary. Momentary light. Magaan lang yan. Akala mo lang mabigat, pastor, ang bigat talaga ng pinagdinaranas ko. Akala mo lang yun. It's momentary and it's light affliction. Whatever it is producing for us an eternal weight. Tignan niyo yung juxtaposition. Juxtaposition mga kapatid. Momentary light affliction. Weight of glory. Weight, light. But this is weight, mabigat of glory. Far beyond all comparison. Whatever problems, difficulties, trials you are experiencing right now, that is momentary light affliction compared to what is awaiting for you in heaven. Let's all stand. Let me close this message. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Ninanais ng Panginoon na tayo palagi mag-rejoice whatever situation we are in. The word of the Lord says, rejoice in the Lord always. I say it again, rejoice. Lagi tayong mag-rejoice sa Panginoon dahil ang Panginoon ang ating reason to rejoice. Not anything in this world, but God is our reason to rejoice. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your message tonight. Lord, nawa po ay ang aming puso ay napuno ng inyong katotohanan. Natuto po kami at nawa po, Lord God, ito po ay mais sa pamuhay po namin. Maraming pong salamat. Ano man po yung sitwasyon po namin, Lord God, mabigat, kasuliranin yung pinagdadaanan po namin. Lord, pinapaalala mo po sa amin that we always have reason to rejoice dahil meron kaming hope in you, O God. Dahil ang aming joy ay nakabase hindi sa lupa ito, Panginoon, sa sanlibutan ito, bagkos sa iyo lamang, Panginoon. Maraming salamat for reminding us to always rejoice, Lord God, no matter what circumstances that we are in, we should always rejoice. We thank you. We magnify your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Everybody say amen.
Amen.